Hello guys, welcome in today's session. I am Professor Fayaz Karwadi from Department of Mechanical Engineering. In today's session, we are going to study how to draw the cam profile for given conditions. This is our part number one from unit number four, cam and follower from theory of machine subject. This problem is already studied while drawing the displacement diagram. So continuation with that same problem, today we are going to study the next part of this, how to draw the cam profile after the displacement diagram. So same problem is taken for your ready reference. I read the problem statement. A cam is to give the following motion to a knife edge follower. Here type of follower is knife edge. Outstroke during 60 degree of cam rotation, dwell for next 30 degree of cam rotation, a return stroke during next 60 degree of cam rotation, and after that dwell for remaining 210 degree of cam rotation. The stroke of the follower is 40 mm. That means this lift of the follower is 40 mm. And the minimum radius of cam is 50 mm. This minimum radius of cam is 50 mm. The follower moves with uniform velocity during both the outward and the return stroke. Draw the profile of cam when cam rotate in clockwise direction. The condition is given in problem statement. The cam is rotated with clockwise direction. If it is not given, it's your choice how to rotate the cam, how to show the rotation of cam in answer. The first is asked in this problem statement is that the axis of the follower passes through the axis of camshaft. In this, the axis of the follower, this axis of the follower passes through the axis of rotation of cam. Okay, and as we have studied in classification of cam and follower, when the axis of the follower and the rotational axis of cam lie on single line, this is called as inline follower or radial follower. Okay, so the procedure to draw the cam profile when the axis of follower and the rotational axis of cam is on same line is different, and the axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of the camshaft. This axis of the follower is offset by 20 mm from the axis of camshaft. Here you can see in this image, the axis of the follower and the axis of rotation of cam is at some distance apart from each other, and that distance is given in problem statement is 20 mm. And when the axis of follower and rotational axis of cam is apart from each other, this type of follower is called as offset follower. These classifications are made is come in the classification of the follower according to the motion of follower, a radial follower and offset follower, that we learned in previous video. I will share the link of that video. Okay, now the procedure to draw the cam profile for radial follower and for offset follower is different. Okay, so in today's video we study how to draw the cam profile for radial follower only. And in next video, I will explain how to draw the cam profile for a radial follower. In same problem statement, both the cases are given. But in examination, only one case may come, either radial follower or offset follower. Okay. Now come to next slide. The displacement diagram that already you have learned in previous video. The for outward stroke and for return stroke, the velocity is uniform. So when uniform velocity of the follower is given, we will draw the straight line for uniform motion of the follower. The displacement curve is straight line, and this straight line is A to G for outward stroke, and H to P is again a straight line for a return stroke. Okay. Now, as per given in problem statement, 60 degree is given outward stroke, 30 degree is dwell period, and After follower is moving downward direction through 60 degree, which is read stroke, and remaining is a dual pivot again. 40 mm is given lift of the follower or stroke of the follower. So you know the procedure how to draw this displacement diagram. With reference to that displacement diagram, we will start the next procedure to draw the cam profile. Okay. Now take the pencil, protractor, compass with you, and step by step along with me start drawing the cam profile. Okay. The first stage is draw the base circle, which is given 40 mm. The radius of the minimum radius of base circle is given in problem statement is 50 mm. I show you here. Here, the minimum radius of cam is 50 mm. Minimum radius of cam. You learn in terminology video, the minimum radius of cam. What is minimum radius of cam? What is base circle? That you learn all the terminologies. So with help of that minimum radius, that distance I will take. That distance I will take in compass 50 mm as a radius, not 50 mm as diameter. In examination, you make the mistake. In problem statement, the radius is given 50 mm. You are taking diameter as 50 mm. Or diameter is given 50 mm. At that time, radius will be 25 mm. So don't make mistake in taking the dimension in compass while drawing the minimum radius of cam or base circle. Okay. So in problem statement, 50 mm radius is given, not diameter. So 50 mm I will take in the compass. Okay. This as a center, I will draw the circle of radius 50 mm, which is a minimum radius of cam. Okay. This is first step. Second step is mark the outward stroke, dwell stroke, and return stroke on that circle. Okay. Before marking, understand that I mark that outward stroke, I will measure that outward stroke in anticlockwise direction. Why? Because in problem statement, it is given that cam is rotating in clockwise direction. If cam is rotating in clockwise direction, my procedure will start in anticlockwise direction. Remember that point. Okay. When cam is rotating in clockwise direction, if it is given in problem statement, you have to mark that angle and you have to measure that angle from anticlockwise direction. Okay. And if it is not given in problem statement, your assumption is that cam is rotating in clockwise direction. So your procedure will always start from anticlockwise direction. So theta outward, which is given 60 degree, you will measure from this vertical line. Okay, why this vertical line? Because at the top of there is a point of knife edge follower. Okay, and the reciprocating axis will be on same vertical line. Okay, so you will measure the outward stroke from this vertical line, which is given 60 degree. Okay, and the next thing that you have to remember while drawing that cam profile, the assumption is that actually the cam is rotating, but while drawing the cam profile, you have to assume that cam is stationary and follower is rotating. Okay, cam is stationary. Actually, in working condition, cam is rotating. But while drawing the cam profile, your assumption should be follower is stationary, cam is stationary, and follower is rotating. Okay, so you have to measure that 60 degree from this vertical axis, which is a outward stroke, theta outward. Okay, with respect to that next line, you have to mark dwell, theta dwell, which is given 30 degree. Okay. So with help of protractor, you will mark the first line, which is 60 degree outward stroke is given. Then second, mark the horizontal line, which is 30 degree from this reference line. And next, a return stroke theta r again, which is given 60 degree, and mark here this third line. And remaining is a dwell period, which is automatically coming as 210 degree. Clear? Now, third step, divide that outward stroke into even number of equal parts. Divide the outward stroke into even number of equal parts. I divide that outward stroke into six number of equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Why I divide that into six number of equal parts? Because in displacement diagram, I divide that outward stroke into six number of equal parts. Okay. If I divide that outward stroke in displacement diagram, eight number of equal parts, I will divide that outward stroke into eight number of equal parts. Okay. So displacement diagram is the reference for drawing the cam profile. So if you make mistake while drawing the displacement diagram, your cam profile will be again, you make mistake. Okay. So don't make mistake, clearly understand the problem statement, clearly read the problem statement and plot the data as per given in problem statement. So be careful. Okay. So outward stroke I divide into six number of equal part as I divide the outward stroke in displacement diagram, six number of equal parts. Okay. So one part will be of 10 degree. Outward stroke is given 60 degree. So I divide that outward stroke into six number of equal parts. So one part will be of 10 degree. Okay. Then dwell period is given. So need not necessary to divide the dwell period, as dwell period is stationary, no displacement here. So need not necessary that dwell period to divide. Then next step is give the numbers to that divisions. First part is a zero. Then first number is zero. Then first part, second, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. These are six equal parts of outward stroke. Then next step is divide return stroke also into same number of equal part as divide in displacement diagram. Here you can see in displacement diagram, the return stroke is also divided into six number of equal parts. So I divide that outward stroke again into six number of equal parts. So one part will be again here of 10 degree. Okay. Again, I give the numbers here like a return stroke. This six, as it is a returning here. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and last one is zero. Okay. But in displacement diagram, number is given here 0-1-2-3-4-5. Don't worry in giving the numbers. Okay, you can change the number here also. This is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and again last one is a zero. Okay. Now I divide the outward stroke into six number of equal parts. A return stroke again six number of equal parts and give the numbers to all the parts. Now next step is getting the intersection point. Okay, this intersection point I will get from displacement diagram. Okay, that first line is a zero, first is zero, and then this is the first part. So from the displacement diagram in compass, I will take one as a center and B as distance. So 1B, that much distance I will take in the compass, and I will mark here one as a center and cut one number line at point B. Okay. From displacement diagram, I take the distance 1B, and I will put that distance, I will cut that distance on first number, first line, okay, at point B. Then from the displacement diagram, I take distance 2C, that distance I will take in the compass, okay, and I will mark here on line 2, I will cut that distance on second line at point C. Clearly understand the procedure. Then from the displacement diagram, I will take the distance 3C. I will take from the displacement diagram, I will take distance 3D. In this way, 3D, I will take in the compass 3D and I will cut the 3 number line. This is 3 number line. Okay. 3 as a center, I cut that line at point D. Okay. In this way, I will mark all the point A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay. From the displacement diagram. From the displacement diagram, I take the distance 6G in the compass. Then 6 as a center, because this is a base circle. This is the minimum radius of cam. Okay. So from that base circle, I will 6 as a center and I will cut that 6 number line at point G. In this way, I plot all the points of outward stroke A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now the same procedure I will follow for a return stroke also. A return stroke. Okay. Now I will join these all the points. I will join this A, B, C, D, E, F, G by a smooth curve. Whatever curve is smooth, the examiner will give the more marks to you. Okay. So that curve should be freehand, but it is a smooth, or you can draw this curve with help of French curve also from the instruments. Okay. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. After completing that curve in outward stroke, I will plot that curve in a return stroke also by taking the distance from the displacement diagram and I will plot on this line. Okay. That edge, 6 edge from the displacement diagram, I will show in displacement diagram. This 6 edge or 0 edge. Now the follower is moving downward direction, so distance goes on reducing here. Okay, this distance I will take in the compass, which is equal to this. Okay, and I will mark on line 6 here. Okay, edge. Then 5i, 4j, okay, from the displacement diagram, and I will mark on that line, I will cut on that line and give the names like this, h, j, 4k from displacement diagram and cut the 4 number line here at point k. Then 3l from the displacement diagram in the compass, 3 as a center and I will cut that 3 number line at point l. Then 2m, that much distance in the compass from the displacement diagram. Okay, and 2 as a center, I will cut the line, 2 number line at point M. Then 1n from the displacement diagram in the compass, 1 as a center, I will cut 1 number line at point N. And P is the last point, okay, which is on base circle. Zero displacement, so this point will be last point and I will join H, J, K, L, M, N with help of smooth curve, freehand smooth curve, but that curve should be freehand. Okay, and G and H is again a dwell period, so a radius, this should be continue same radius point, no displacement point. So when this radius will be fixed, displacement will be zero of the follower. That means it is a dwell pivot. So I will join by a smooth same distance, same radius by keeping compass at this point and I will draw the smooth curve G to H. Okay. In this way, I will join that cam profile, join all the points A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P by a smooth curve and I will complete that, and this P to this zero, or this zero to this zero, there is a dual pivot to 110. So this will be, there is no displacement. Okay, in this way I will complete the CAM profile. And if you see in color geometry, in this way you have to draw the CAM profile by a smooth curve. And this is optional. You have to show that knife edge follower on this CAM profile, or you can't draw. That will not affect on your marks. Okay, so in the red color, CAM profile is shown. In this way, the same procedure you have to follow if condition is given in problem statement. Only the change is that the motion of the follower will be changed. For outward stroke, may be given simple harmonic motion, and for return stroke, uniform acceleration and retardation is given, as we discussed in previous session. Any combination will be given, but same distance you have to copy from displacement diagram, and you have to plot on that extension line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this extension line, and cut at these different points and join this by the smooth curve. This is the case when the follower axis and rotational axis of the CAM is in line, or radial CAM. So the same procedure you have to follow while drawing the CAM profile for inline follower or radial follower. Yes, you will expect you understand the procedure for drawing the CAM profile for given condition. Okay, so at the end of the session, student can understood the procedure of drawing CAM profile for inline follower. Thank you for observing this video.